get this show started. Y'all came ready to party. We're going to enjoy each other, and then we're going to enjoy some of the wonderful talent. We've been doing this for how many been here for all the times we've done it? How many times have we done it? 3 years. 3 years. Anybody been here all 3 years? Woo! Welcome back. The faithful keep coming. So they liked what they saw, y'all. How many of you, this is your first time? Woo! Look around. Look around. Where's the camera? Y'all smile for the camera now. I don't have one, but you know. We got you. We got you. Well, I want to welcome you to the 3rd annual Seniors Got Talent. And you know, for us to be able to do this for 3 years, it says that DeKalb County must have a lot of talent. And I know all of you all could very well be up here on stage, but you chose to take your place in the seats where you could clap for those who are brave enough to share with us what has been put into them. So I want to thank our DeKalb Library System, who is responsible for this event. Y'all know I'm over 60, so I have to go back to my cheat sheet. Let's see. Okay. And if I forget, y'all, guess what you can do? You can look back yonder. It's all back there, okay? But I want to really give a special shout out to Allison Wessinger. Are you here, Allison? Who is the director of libraries in DeKalb County. So y'all give her a big shout out. She had the vision, and she brought this to life. Also, Teresa Totten and Miguel Chappelle. Are you all here? Come on, Teresa. Let's get a few comments from Teresa. Come on down. Woo, come on, girl. Do it. All right. Welcome, Teresa Totten.
Thank you. Hello, everybody. Hello. Welcome. Thank you again for joining us for our 3rd annual Seniors Got Talent. How many have been, you've been here for all 3? Anybody? It's a great show, and we look forward to hosting this every year. I am Teresa Totten. I am the Adult Services Programming Coordinator for the DeKalb County Library System. And let me just say this, a shameless plug for the library system, the 2018 Georgia Public Library System of the Year. Okay. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you so much for your support over the years for this event. We look forward to some amazing talent today. And we look forward to you supporting them when they come up and be so brave to get up here and share their amazing talent with you. All right. Thank you so much. Have a great show.
Thank you. And you'll hear from Miguel Chappelle later on in the show. We also want to give a big thanks to Damon Scott, the Human Services Division of DeKalb County. Are you here? Anybody from Damon's office here? He's over all of the centers in DeKalb County. We also have our other partner, Lou Walker Senior Center, Ms. Shakita Thompson. Come on down. All right.
Hey. All right, so we just want to give a special thanks to Human Services because they make all of this happen. Human Services is over the entire division as far as the neighborhood senior centers, DeKalb Atlanta, woo! South DeKalb, North DeKalb, Lou Walker, Central. He's over all of that, plus Youth Services and the Grants Administration. So it's a lot of things that we're trying to push through these centers and through these different departments to get everybody active, and that's his vision, is excellence in DeKalb, and that's what we shoot for in all of our centers. So we just welcome, thank you. I'm Chiquita Thomas. I'm over at Lou Walker, They're special. They have a special place in my heart, but I love all the centers. So that's why we try to do things to combine everybody and connect everybody so we know who we are, because we all share that same vision of excellence in DeKalb. All right, so we're going to get this party started. I'm giving this back to them.
All right, I want everybody to reach in your purse, your pockets, and pull out your phone. We're going to make it light. We're going to make it something up in here. Pull out your phone, okay? Now, go to quiet or silent or off or mute. Those are your choices, okay? And turn off your phone so that it's not part of the televised event. The event will be televised, just the revolution won't, okay? So we won't, because we will put the camera on you if your phone rings, okay? So we don't want to be infamous in a famous environment, right? Okay, we're going to get this party started again. It has been warmed up. You know, you always have the praises go first, and then you got the event come out. Well, we had Miss Shakita come out here and get us warmed up, and we are ready for the talent. So the first one I want to bring to the stage is our winner. Is the winner of the very first Seniors Got Talent. She's no stranger to any of us. We've seen her do many renditions. I bring to you the new people who are here for the first time, and I remind others of this great talent we have in Miss Clovis Clark. Let's say it together. Still, I rise. Go, Clovis.
You may write me down in history with your bitter, twisted lies. You may trod me in the very dirt, but still, like dust, I'll rise. Does my sassiness upset you? Why are you beset with gloom? 'Cause I walk like I've got all wells pumping in my living room. Just like moons and like suns, with the certainty of tides. Just like hopes springing high, still I'll rise. You want to see me broken? Bowed head and lowered eyes, shoulders falling down like teardrops, weakened by my soulful cries. Does my haughtiness offend you? Don't you take it off heart, 'cause I laugh. Got gold mines digging in my own backyard. You may shoot me with your words. You may cut me with your eyes. You may kill me with your hatefulness. But still, like air, I'll rise. Does my sexiness upset you? Does it come as a surprise that I dance like I've got diamonds at the meeting of my thighs? Out of the huts of history's shame, I rise up from a past that's rooted in pain. Rise! I'm a black motion, leaping and wide, welling and swelling, I bear in the tide, leaving behind nights of terror and fear. I rise into a daybreak that's wondrously clear. I rise, bringing the gifts that my ancestor gave. I am the dream and the hope of the slave. I rise. That is a poem by Maya Angelou. And what that means is that our people will never, ever surrender to slavery again.
All right. All right. Say it with me. No matter what, I rise. Because I know who I am. You see, when you know who you are, the world can't tell you nothing about you. You can either identify with what they say, or you can stand for who you have been created to be. So today, I see a room full of those who have stood for what they were created to be. We're going to get ready with the next act. And until they are, they know I don't have a problem continuing to help them along the way. So I want to see our lights up just a little bit. Lights up just a little bit in the audience. All my medal winners for this great 2019 senior month, older Americans month. We're no longer seniors. We're now older Americans. Okay? So all older Americans, and that could be 15, 25, 35, 55, 65, 75. So all old, 85, 95, 105. Just had to cover the whole gamut. Okay, all of older Americans who won a medal this year, please stand. Let's give them a big hand. All right, great job. We're going to keep on going with the show. We have coming to you right now Ann Gardner and Lynn Stone, and they are going to do a duo. We are not telling you a lot about what they're doing in the beginning because we want you to be entertained, and because I don't know, okay? We have coming before us right now Ann Gardner and Lynn Stone. Let's welcome them with a rousing hand of applause.
Thank you.
Next, we have Miss Leela Banks. All right. Leela got some sisters in the house. And Leela will be declaring by way of song, "The Blood Will Never," and you finish that, "Never Lose Its Power." Miss Leela Banks, let's give it up for Miss Leela.
How's everybody doing? The blood that Jesus shed for me way back on Calvary, the blood that gives me strength from day to day, it will never lose its power. Oh, it reaches to the highest mountain. That gives me strength from day to day. It will never lose its power. Oh, it reaches to the high. And it flows to the lowest valley. Oh, yeah, the blood that gives me strength from day to day. His power, don't you know, it reaches to the highest mountain, and it flows to the lowest valley. Oh, yeah, the blood that gives me strength from day to day, it will never lose. I said it'll never lose. One more time, it'll never lose its power.
I believe Ms. Banks knows that the blood, it still works. We're moving on with the show. Say, moving on. All right, we're going to go now to a little bit of levity with Mad Dog Comedy. Mr. Mad Dog.
dog.
Heavy pump, hot, 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 and bad.
What's up, DeKalb County? Y'all having a good time today? I don't care. Hey, anybody out there need milk? I got my milk outfit on. See, don't deliver milk no more. You try to deliver milk now, you might get shot and get your milk taken. But one thing I've just found out about myself, I just found out that I'm faster than Megabus, Greyhound, The Flash, Superman, and Forrest Gump. Let me tell you how I found out. I accidentally rubbed some icy hot on my hemorrhoids. Hey, I'm leaping buildings at a single bound. I gotta get Bubba. I already got him. But any ladies out here being beat up or mistreated or anything? Anybody? See? Okay. There's no need to fear. Mad Dog is here. And this ring is filled with a Mad Dog super energy pill. And it ain't Viagra. It's an aspirin. But what I'm really waiting on, is I'm waiting on the Red Fox audition. I'll fly to Hollywood. I will represent Red Fox. Red Fox ain't dead. Because Steady Freddy is ready. All right? Now, all y'all mothers, I know y'all had nice Mother's Day. I did something nice. I prepared breakfast for my friend. So she was upstairs. So I yelled, "Babe, babe, what you going to drink with breakfast? You want Tang or you want OJ?" She said, "Babe, fix me a glass of Tang." I said, "I know that's right, because that OJ will kill you." I'm just saying. She told me she was getting bored. She wanted to go someplace different for a change. I said, "Try the kitchen." I told her, they still got some Mother's Day sales out there. I said, "You could go get anything you want, just don't get caught. Because you're on your own." I've been bad. But I'm going to keep it short. But ladies, tomorrow is Friday. You don't have to go to the club. Pick you up a bottle of Mad Dog, give me a call, and I'll bring the cups and the ice. We can party all night. And the party be like, "Ooh, Mr. Sexy Man, what's your name here? What's your name here? Ooh, Mr. Sexy Man, what's your name? The name is Mad Dog.
Mr. Mad Dog, ain't nothing wrong with a little bit of levity, a little comedy. Because it's good for the heart. So everybody do like this. Smile. It's not laugh. Ha! It's good for the heart. We're going to move right on. We're bringing to the stage Latin Rhythm. Have we not? We had a little comedy, little dance, little gospel, little instrumental, and a little levity. Moving right along. Say, moving on. Moving on. All right, we're going to bring to the stage Miss Annie Beasley to close to the mirror. Too close to the mirror.
Good morning, Porter Sanford. This song here just bring me down to earth and remind me that I'm no better than anyone else.
Guess I'm too close to the mirror to see what you see. While you shower down your blessings on me. It's not anything I've done, Lord, as far as I can see. I guess I'm too close to the mirror to see what you see in me.
Sometimes I think about the things he has done for me. How he washed away all my sins and set my spirit free. When I look back over my life, I haven't always done right. Still his goodness and his mercy follow me every day of my life. I believe that
I'm too close to the mirror to see what he sees. While he shower down his blessings, his blessings on me. It's not anything I've done, Lord, as far as I can see. I guess I'm too close to the mirror to see what you see in me.
Let me tell you what else. See, I thought about giving up. He said, trust in me. If you hold on and faint not, keep your faith in me. Lord, you don't see me like I am. You see me like I'm gonna be. So I believe I'll run on and see what the end's gonna be. I believe that
I'm too close to the mirror to see what you see.
All right.
While you shower down your blessings on me.
I sure don't understand. Not anything I've done, Lord, as far as I can see.
I guess I'm too close to the mirror to see what you see in me.
Help me sing that, okay?
Yes, I'm too close to the mirror to see what you see. While you shower down your blessings on me.
I sure don't understand.
Not anything I've done, Lord, as far as I can see. I guess I'm too close to the mirror to see what you see in me. Guess I'm too close to the mirror.
Hallelujah.
To see what you see. While you shower down your blessings on me.
I sure don't understand.
Not anything I've done, Lord, as far as I can see.
I guess I'm too close to the mirror. I believe that I'm too close to the mirror. I know that I'm too close to the mirror to see what he sees in me. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you.
Miss Annie Beasley, give it up, too close to the mirror. Sometimes when we don't have a mirror, we can see it the way we want to see it. But it's something about, and don't take a picture. Oh my goodness. It's captured in time. I think I'd rather have the mirror than to have a picture. All right. We have somebody's secret card. If you dropped it on purpose, thank you. If you dropped it by accident, we have it for you. Just see us after the event, and we'll give it to you, okay? If this looks familiar, Saflock. Very exquisite place. Saflock. Okay. Moving on. With our talent, we are bringing to the stage next Mr. John Colthrop. On the way, to Avalon. Give it up for Mr. John Colthrop on the way to Avalon.
Thank you. Thank you all for having this, and thank you for inviting me to come. I'm glad to be here. Can you hear me?
No.
Closer. Can you hear me now? All right. All right. All right. Moving up. Like this? Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. This is a very active audience. Thank you. My thing is to read a poem that I wrote some years ago and have been amending since. It's an unpublished poem. It's about running. And it's also about the end of a relationship. Uh-huh, uh-huh. Anybody ever had an ending of a relationship? Anybody ever lost in a relationship? All right, so you know where I'm coming from. So it's about, and I'll tell you this, it's many years ago, I was a runner. I spent a lot of time running. And I ran 10Ks to marathons. But my regular run was from Decatur to Avondale, uh-huh, and back. It was a pretty easy run back then. So my subject is about running. But you can run in different ways. Horizontally and vertically. Decatur to Avondale is horizontal. Decatur to Avondale is horizontal. You got that. Decatur to Avalon is vertical. Vertical represents remembrance, being lost in transition, dangling, anger, disgust, and stuckness. So this is about a relationship, about the aftermath of a relationship where you can't let go and you can't go on. All right. So some of you may have been there. You feel run over. You feel floored. And all that good stuff, right? So part of this, I talk about this lady who I act like she's having a hard time. She didn't have a hard time because she was the one leaving. She had a new relationship, so she was happy. But I like to think of her not happy. So this is a narrative poem about that. On the Way to Avalon, dedicated to Don Quixote. I am running, running down Ponce de Leon, running over the earth and through the rain from Decatur to Avalon. Running fast, I ask, and how was I to go? What do I know? I know nothing. Overhead, it rains a sad refrain, and I am running through the rain. Over there, I spy Decatur Square. Someone I know awaits me there. At the Huddle House, she sits alone. Her coffee cold to the bone. And who's to blame? Perhaps the rain. And I am running fast, troubled and light. The day is bleak. The world is deep, and deep my breathing. Your changing color makes me love hate. And I cannot blow out the candles. It's one hell of a way to Avalon. So run on, sweet youth, run on. And you, love child, sing your song. Like a bird from a distant land. Forget your tears. Shop. Call a friend. Sleep if you can. Let dreams bathe your swollen eyes, washing your soul clean and black. Like a cold, hard stone. Woe is me. I've run slap out. I'm tired of running toward Avalon. I'll take the MARTA home instead. Yeah. Thank you. To ride the rail from Avondale. I'll stop by Candler Park to visit a girl who I know has liked me from afar. She'll be happy to see me. I'll sit by a window or in a chair and start to remember when and where. I'll drift in and out. There we go. Softly, she'll inquire, "Did you have a bad run?" "No, no," I'll lie. "Not bad at all. A cup of chocolate, dear?" What did you say?" "What's wrong?" she'll ask. "I don't understand. Where are you now?" I'll shake my head left and right. "What shall I say?" And turning toward a window or a picture on the wall, I'll reply, "I'm running toward Avalon."
Thank you, Mr. John Calthrop. Been writing that poem a long time because it's a long way to Avalon, isn't it?
It's a long way. Years.
All right, give it up again, John Calthrop. Next, we're bringing to the stage a male singing duo, Mr. Ronald Lewis and Mr. Lord Allman. Come on down. Give it up for Mr. Allman and Mr. Lewis, dressed sophisticatedly. He wants my mic.
Thank you. find a word, my love, to tell you how I feel, my love. Mere words could not explain. Precious love, you held my life within your hand, created everything I am, taught me how to live again.
Mr. Ron Lewis and Mr. Lloyd Alleman, thank you all so much for that original rendition of that historic song. Next, coming to the stage, we have a poetry recital, Miss Betty Tucker. Come on down, Miss Betty Tucker. Give her a big hand.
I have a secret to tell you. Buckle your seatbelts. It's never too late to follow your dreams. At 70 years old, I moved to Atlanta, Georgia to accelerate my creative endeavor. As an inspirational speaker, as a playwriter, and as an author, I wrote a memoir, It's Never Too Late to Follow Your Dreams. I want to share with you my three-step process. Rekindle that joy. You know your likes, your dislikes, your moods. The challenge facing most of us is that sometimes life and all that comes with it has a way of suppressing our joy and pleasure. Step two, resurface that one thing that brought you the most joy. What is it? Once you realize what brings you the most joy, that's going to motivate you to rekindle that joy and pleasure. Start peeling back layers of the things that you enjoyed when you were a child, when you were an adolescent. That will help you rekindle that joy. According to Jeremiah 29:11 states, "For I have plans for you, declared the Lord. I will prosper you and I will not harm you. I will give you hope in a future." God truly does have plans for all of us. He wants us to have dreams and a greater desire to follow our dreams. The only thing that can stop you or stand in your way of bettering your life and following your dreams is you. I challenge you to start living your best life, and every day would be a masterpiece. If I can do it, you can do it too. Thank you.
All right. Entitled, It's Never Too Late to Follow. Thank you, Miss Betty Tucker. And next coming to the stage, como quisiera decirte, Miss Mercedes Beto. Miss Mercedes Beto.
Have you ever been in love? So much in love that you just want to tell the person how much you love them. And you're just dying to tell them. That's what this is about. I'm waiting for the song. The music. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm waiting for the music. Como quisiera decirte algo que llevo aquí dentro, clavado como una espina. Y así va pasando el tiempo, sin atinar a decirte lo que a diario voy sintiendo, por temor quizás de oírte. Que cuando contemplo el cielo, pues ella me va diciendo cómo me faltan tus besos, cómo quisiera decirte que me escuches un momento. Tu estrella me va diciendo cómo me faltan tus besos. Cómo quisiera decirte que eres mi amor, mi lucero. Que de sentirte tan lejos de a poco me estoy muriendo. Que quiero que estés conmigo como en un final de cuentos. como quisiera decirte, decirte cuánto te quiero, como quisiera decirte, decirte cuánto te quiero.
Thank you. Thank you. Commercial break. We're going to take 5 minutes. Commercial break right now. We have an announcement to make. DeKalb for Seniors is sponsoring a community garden project. And the purpose of this project is to memorialize loved ones or leave a legacy for yourself. They will be in the lobby during the lunch period, so you can ask questions about how you can take part in this brick fund. So, DeKalb for Seniors, memorialize your loved ones or leave a legacy yourself. Please inquire.
Bathed in beauty. It felt like it was only yesterday when your eyes attracted me to you. The intensity of your God-blessed smile was equally matched with the strength in your hands as you gently, lovingly coaxed me into your arms. Rarely do you feel the need to tell me I'm your queen, because your waking hours unapologetically demonstrates your words. You encourage us to share our deepest, darkest, most painful secrets, because that's the only way our souls will begin to entwine. The shadow you cast over me serves as a reminder that you will not let anything or anyone damage me, or damage you, or damage us. It's what my king does, and yes, I love it. You need to massage my ego only after we've shared each other's wisdom. Our love is not contrived, cannot be denied, will not be quantified, but will always be realized as just that. It's ours. A treasure seeker's delight. In the cracks and crevices of life, there are precious jewels. These jewels are rare and often remain undiscovered, unnoticed to the untrained mind. The mere thought that these jewels exist are usually relegated to simple stories and unsubstantiated myths. These jewels are often perfect in size, shape, and color, each with its own version of unique radiance, indescribable brilliance, and its value, well, its value is priceless. And believe it or not, each jewel has its own story of survival, from possession to obsession, from misuse to unspeakable abuse. It can be the purveyor of hope, heaven, or hell. When found, as with most things deemed precious, the jewel is tested for its level of perfection, clarity, flawlessness, its ability to withstand the winds of change and the storms of adversity. And when meticulously cared for, the jewel flourishes, and although it was not the intention, the tale of the discovery of the jewel emits thoughts of jealousy, envy, admiration, or, oh yes, greed. The trained mind of a treasure seeker will realize not only the necessity to hold the jewel tight, but to honor it, respect it, while constantly being amazed by its reliable resilience. The trained mind of a treasure seeker will thank the heavens above for what has been found. Only two questions remain. Will you recognize the treasure? Will you recognize the jewel when you find her? Thank you.
From a writer's point of view, keep it moving, keep it moving. We're bringing now to the stage Miss Deborah Stackhouse. Stackhouse in the moment, song improv. Miss Deborah Stackhouse, give it up.
You like a little reggae? So if you feel like dancing, just move your body, okay? In my soul, I feel it. Reggae music, I can hear it. Reggae music in my soul. I hear the rhythm. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Reggae music. Hear it in your body. Move your body now. Hey, can you feel it? Can you feel it? Oh, just reggae music for my soul. Just the reggae music makes me just the reggae music of my soul. Can you feel the reggae? Can you feel the music? Can you feel the moment that we are in? You feel good to my soul. I need you to make me whole. Oh, if you feel the reggae music, move your body. Reggae music for your soul. Feel the reggae music. Ooh, 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 ooh. For my soul. For your soul. Feel it, yeah, 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 yeah. Feel it, oh, 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 oh. I thank the Creator spirit. I thank thank the creator. Yeah. Oh, reggae music. Thank you.
All right, Stackhouse in the moment. Deborah Stackhouse.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. All right, keeping it moving, keeping it moving. We're bringing to the stage a hula dance. Miss Kitty Winbush. Put your hands together and welcome Miss Kitty Winbush.
Night and new and blue Hawaii. The night is heavenly, and you are heaven to me.
Thank you, Miss Winbush, for taking us to Hawaii for a hula dance. All right, moving, keep it moving. So keep it moving. We are fortunate now to bring to the stage Miss Arlene McGuire, doing things my way. Miss Arlene McGuire, give her a big hand.
Thank you. It's been a favorite song of my mom and dad and myself. And last year I beat cancer and I decided I'm going to do it my way.
Final curtain. My friends, I'll say it clear. I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full. I've traveled each and every byway and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Regrets, oh, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do. I saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step on the highway, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew, and through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. Nice to tall and taste it all, and did it my way. I've loved, oh, I've laughed, I've cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing. Now as tears subside, I find it all so damn amusing. To think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. No, not me, I did it my way. For what is a man, what has he got, if not himself, then he has not to say the things he truly feels, and not the words. On wheels, the record show, I took the blows and did it my way.
All right. How many of us can say we had to sometimes do things our own way? We had to create a way, because we know one who will make a way, create a road in the wilderness. We're keeping it moving. South DeKalb, creative dancers, sweet spirit, take over this place. Welcome them. Big hand for the DeKalb creative dancers.
Praise your name, Jesus. It's an honor you, and we worship you today. We invite your spirit into this house, your glory, your presence, O Lord. Abba, Father, we bless you. Lord Jesus, we give praise to you. Holy Spirit, we welcome you tonight. Somebody lift your hands and make him feel welcome in this house. It's not about us tonight. It's all about him, his wisdom, his grace, and his mercy. The rising of the sun to the going down of the same. Your name is to be praised. So sing to you.
Sweet Spirit.
take over this place. Take over this place, sweet spirit. Sweet spirit, take over this place. Take over this sweet spirit.
Sweet spirit.
Sweet spirit.
Sweet spirit.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Sweet spirit.
Sweet spirit.
Sweet spirit.
Sweet spirit.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Sweet spirit.
Sweet spirit. Somebody stretch out your hands. Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Sweet spirit.
Sweet spirit.
Sweet spirit.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Mighty spirit.
Mighty spirit.
Mighty spirit.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Mighty spirit.
Mighty spirit.
Mighty spirit.
Mighty spirit.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Holy spirit.
Holy spirit.
Holy spirit.
Holy spirit.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Healing Spirit.
Healing Spirit.
Healing Spirit.
Healing Spirit.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Healing Spirit.
Healing Spirit.
Healing Spirit.
You can take over this place.
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 Take over this place. Can you help us say that?
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over my heart.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over this place.
Take over my mind.
Thank you, South DeKalb Creative Dancers. Sweet Spirit, take over this place. Moving on, say, keep it moving. All right, y'all ready for lunch? I hear it, I hear it. The improvable, improvables, an improv surprise. Welcome the improvables.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. We are the Improvables, an
improv group that was formed 5 years ago at Emory's OSHA Lifelong Learning Institute.
And an improv is a story that we're going to tell based on your suggestion. And today, we're going to do a monologue for you, which, as everyone knows, is a story told by five people.
So from you, the audience, I want a suggestion. And what I'm thinking about is an exotic place you'd love to visit, whether or not you're able to, but would love to visit. Somebody name some exotic places. Tahiti, Hawaii. Hawaii. I like Paris, but I think I chose Hawaii. So we're good.
My brother Bob was getting married for the third time to the lovely Corinne. And they decided to have a destination wedding in Hawaii. I've always wanted to go to Hawaii.
but I didn't know how I was going to get there.
Except I knew I had to buy a ticket. The other thing I knew I had to do was probably learn to dance the hula, because I knew they were going to make us do that at the reception.
So I went to Kmart and I bought a hula hoop. And I went home and I stepped into that hula hoop and I twirled it and it fell down.
So I watched it on the floor and I said, heck with that, I think I'll do the salsa, because that's the way to do it in Hawaii.
Because in Hawaii, if I'm doing the salsa, rather than looking at that wretched Corinne, they'll be looking at me. So.
And everybody knows that I'm supposed to be the most important person at the reception. After all, I am the brother of the bride.
But I noticed in the other side of the room was my nemesis, Mad Dog. Oh, my God. And he was standing there staring at me with those Mad Dog eyes.
And copying down notes on things we were saying. Well, I'm just going to keep on dancing because Mad Dog can't do the hula.
And Mad Dog came up to me and said, would you like a glass of Mad Dog whiskey? I said, sure. Well, I was
desperate to have a Mad Dog whiskey, but all my guests are going to get drunk way too soon. And what kind of wedding is that going to be? They'll be out there on the beach hula-ing and salsa-ing, and I'm not going to know who's who because I can't remember a thing.
And then I noticed that the lovely Corinne was making eyes at Mad Dog. And I was so jealous. I could feel myself turning green. And as I got greener and greener.
And I thought it must be the whiskey. But you know, Mad Dog was starting to look better and better. So I said, just give me another shot. That Mad Dog whiskey. And Mad Dog, he pulls it out. He's got a little shot. So I take
a shot, but then I heard boom, boom. Well, I am on Hawaii. Is that a volcano or is that my hangover? I couldn't figure out what it would be at all at a wedding in Hawaii. So I decided, well, if it's a volcano, we'll just take a helicopter ride up there and watch it. And the heck with the volcano or the relatives or anyone else.
But it was a hangover. So Mad Dog said, hey, I've got some aspirin in my pocket for that.
And I think I'm going to go ahead and ask Corinne to marry me.
Thinking on your feet, improv, an improv surprise, one sentence told by five people. Great. Say, keep it moving. All right. I want to first ask the volunteers, the lunchtime volunteers, if you would meet Shakita in the lobby area, please. Lunchtime volunteers. Y'all excuse them as they step across you because they're getting things ready for us. All right, all lunchtime volunteers are leaving, and we're going on with our show. Bringing to the stage now Miss Gloria McCrary, The Creation. Give it up for Miss Gloria McCrary.
Come on, y'all, walk with me, won't you? Thank you.
good. You know, sometimes you just got to take a little moment to take a deep breath and say, that's good. That's good. Moving on. Keep it moving. All right. We're bringing to the stage now Johnny Hood. You were born to love. Give it up for Miss Johnny Hood.
Kimi wa, I saw le ruta me. Kimi no shota iwa, arimiti te ilu. Kimi wa, I saw le ruta me. Kimi no shota iwa, arimiti te ilu. A and no, come and no, iwa wa re re no. Day and no, naka day, mi o mu sabu. Kimi sangza iwa, watashi niwa, dore ho do ho kina, yoroko be the shore. Kimi wa hai sane rutame umarita, imai mo sano nai, uke te ilu. Ike masano nai, ike te ilu.
All right, Ms. Hood, thank you for that Japanese rendition. You were born to love. Anybody got that? Anybody understood it? Y'all, did y'all get it? Well, welcome to Japan. All right, moving on. We're bringing to the stage now, Over the Rainbow, Precious B. Jones. Let's give it up.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Now, I'm gonna sing Somewhere Over the Rainbow. Judy Garland sang it in The Wizard of Oz in 1939. I got her lyrics in front of me. So, a cappella, here I go. Somewhere over the rainbow, way up high, there's a land that I heard of once in a lullaby. Somewhere over the rainbow, skies are blue, and the dreams that you dare to dream really do come true. Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me, where troubles melt like lemon drops away above the chimney tops. That's where you'll find me, somewhere over the rainbow. Blue birds fly, birds fly over the rainbow. Why, then why can't I? If happy little bluebirds fly beyond the rainbows, why, oh, why can I? Thank you.
right, somewhere over the rainbow. A cappella. All right, it's coming now to an end. We are going to bring our last talent competitor to the stage, the ribbon dance, Miss Lisa Chen. Welcome, Miss Lisa Chen, to the stage. We've been to Asia, we've been to South America, we've been to Hawaii, we've been to the Port of Sanford Center on Rainbow Drive, Decatur, Georgia, and we have been entertained. Have you enjoyed the talent? It's been a great time. I'm yours truly, Annette Hill. It's been my joy and pleasure to serve you this morning. And now I want to bring to the stage, I love my family, y'all. Now I want to bring to the stage the man of the hour, Mr. Miguel Chappelle. On your feet and say, come on, Miguel.
Y'all ready for the winners? Very good. Let me make sure I approve. Just kidding. Come on. I want to thank some people before we go into that. We have a team that made this happen. Shakita is probably around the lunch table. She's from Lou Walker Senior Center. We want to thank Lou Walker Senior Center volunteers. Shakita, give them a hand. We also want to take time to thank Port of Sanford for allowing us to use their space. Also providing us with their volunteers. They're the ones in all black. And I want to thank the library team right next to me. Over to the right is Gina Jenkins and Teresa Totten. They have been my yoga for this event, keeping me calm. So, the first, we'll go from third. We have three winners, okay? We'll start with third place, okay? The third place winner is Leela Banks. The blood will never lose its power. The second place winner is Deborah Stackhouse. Stackhouse in the moment. Deborah Stackhouse. Did Stackhouse leave the house? Oh, she's coming. Okay. All right. Our 2019 Seniors Got Talent first place winner is Lisa Chin. Lisa Chin. Second place trophy. Now this is the catch. We'll award trophies for the first two, but all of these people will walk away with $100 for winning the competition.